共和党的初选正在如火如荼的进行当中，基本上我们已经知道谁会代表共和党了，但是川普的对手会是谁呢？会是 Joe Biden 吗？最近有非常多的声音在网络上面说 Joe Biden 根本不会参选，而且并不是从保守派出来的声音，说法是大选前的最后一秒，拜登可能会宣布放弃参选，可能会推上来 Gavin Newsom 或者是 Michelle Obama 这样的候选人。我不知道，我觉得这样的说法很难说服我，但是如果推行的是民主党的话呢，这个就是非常有可能的可能了。看着拜登的民调还有各个共和党的候选人对上拜登的假设民调，可能民主党必须放弃拜登，而且已经开始了。各位应该可以感觉到整个民主党的方向在改变，主流媒体、新闻、谈话性节目对上这位史上最亲民、得票数最高、最伟大的总统，从林肯纪念碑延伸出来的两道光束，就像Joe Biden的这个双臂拥抱着美国一样。Joe Biden同志，长龙长龙，崇恩的思密达。现在出来的东西却完全不是这么一回事。那我们要来先问一下这个问题：谁是Joe Biden最大的支持者？谁一直在推崇爹亲娘亲不如Joe Biden的共产党亲？民主党亲？当然就是我们加州最美丽的 Nancy Pelosi。
This president did such a remarkable job. He is a person of such knowledge, such vision for the country, such knowledge of the issues, such strategic thinking, and such a legislator. And on top of it all, a person who connects with the American people. He just has to get out there.
根据 Nancy Pelosi 的说法， Joe Biden、他是我们这个脚前的灯、路上的光还是什么的， Joe Biden 是他们的红太阳。 Joe Biden 不仅仅是史上最伟大的总统，而且是这历史上他在地球上绿地的走过的最伟大的人类。但是现在却不同了。根据 Daily Mail 的报道， Nancy Pelosi 证实拜登可能退出2024的选举之后，笑着拒绝回答 Kamala Harris 是否是最好的副总统候选人。我们来看一下。
Why is there such concern among a lot of Democrats about him?
Well, I travel a bit in those circles of Democrats nationally and politically, and while there may be some concerns, everybody's for him.That overwhelmingly everybody's for him.
Do you think there's any chance he does not continue running?
I hope not. I hope not. I mean, this president.
David Ignatius recently came out saying he thinks the former president should not run.
Yeah, so that's one.
Is Vice President Kamala Harris the best running mate for this president?
He thinks so, and that's what matters. And by the way, she's very politically astute. I don't think people give her enough credit.She, of course, values-based, consistent with the president's values and the rest. And people don't understand, she's politically astute. Why would she be vice president if she were not? But when she was running for attorney general in California, she had 6% in the polls. 6% in the polls. And she politically astutely made her case about why she would be good, did her politics, and became attorney general. So people shouldn't underestimate what...Kamala Harris brings to the table.
有没有可能拜登会放弃竞选？我希望不会。I hope not. 所以这已经不是绝对不可能了，他不可能退选哦，他是我们的红太阳，他怎么可能会退选呢？而是我希望他不要退选啊。但是you know, 那如果只是 Nancy Pelosi 这个样子的话，那就算了。但是不是的。华盛顿邮报几天前发了个头条，摆在最前页，大字粗体，标题是总统拜登在2024不该再度参选。
You may. Go ahead.
The piece is entitled President Biden Should Not Run Again in 2024. And in it you write, quote, Biden wrote his political testament in his inaugural address.When our days are through, our children and our children's children will say of us, they gave their best, they did their duty, they healed a broken land. Mr. President, maybe this is that moment when duty has been served. Biden would carry two big liabilities into a 2024 campaign. He would be 82 when he began a second term, And according to a recent Associated Press NORC poll, 77% of the public think he is too old to be effective for 4 more years. And the fact that he has beaten Trump, I don't know why you would question his ability to beat him again. There are other presidents who are later in years, including the Republican presumptive nominee. Is this really about Kamala Harris?
And it seemed to me through this summer, I haven't gone anywhere in the country. I haven't talked to any group of people where this issue of whether President Biden should run again hasn't been a centerpiece of conversation. It doesn't get into the newspapers. It doesn't get much on TV except Fox News, which is obsessed with it. And I thought that it was time to raise that question. And again, the heart of it is whether Joe Biden is the best person to carry this legacy forward. He may decide that he's the only person who can defeat Donald Trump. I mean, he sees that as his mission. It's why he ran in the first place back in 2019. He may decide he's the guy who can do it and nobody else can. And that's his decision. But I felt it was time to have a more public discussion about this.
就连亚马逊的总裁 Jeff Bezos 的公司 OK 华盛顿邮报的记者 David Ignatius 都这个样说了。这个人刚刚在 MSNBC 上面赞叹拜登，敬爱拜登，拥抱拜登的左派记者，就连他都在用他的平台跟拜登说，别再参选了 Joe please OK， 为了防止世界被破坏，为了维护世界的和平，贯彻爱与真实的邪恶，可爱又迷人的反派角色，拜登拜托不要再参选2024的总统了。听起来不太像是一个为了拜登背书的宣言。他在上面讲说、哦、拜登好棒哦，史上最棒的人类 OK， 耶稣在水上行走，拜登简直就是轻功水上漂啊，跟圣灵一样运行在水面上。他在国际的政策你有看到吗？他在阿富汗做的事情 OK， 10 out of 10 十分满意。他制止了川普，然后把司法部当成了他的武器，用政府的力量攻击政敌，起诉川普跟川普的跟攻击川普的支持者，甚至杀了反对他的人，好棒哦，太棒了。但是请不要再选2024了，拜托。总之就是很蠢，前后根本接不上。不只是这个样子， New York Times 纽约时报的报道的标题是2024的场上噩梦，噼里啪啦噼里啪啦讲了一大堆跟棒球有关的形容方式。就像我每次写稿都会被 Felicia 跟 Priscilla 骂说，哎，你讲这么多废话，那么多形容词根本没人看懂的例子干嘛，可不可以说重点啊。总之就是一串又一串虚假的鼓励跟赞美之后，这篇报道写道，但是让拜登竞选2024，民主党在做一个改变人生的赌注。这个成功的管理系统可能有两种意外的危机，造成下一个选举有非常高的价码。可能他的身体健康是一个可以被川普攻击的方式，导致川普回到白宫。接下来的四年必须要面对的可能危机，里面用的字眼非常棒 ，OK， slippage 摔倒。然后这篇文章继续说，球永远会找到你，那个就是棒球永远会跟着你的意思。当然不是一个没有变数的事实，很有可能拜登可以跌跌撞撞赢得另一个选举，他的第二任不会有更糟糕的事情发生，不像雷根总统的第二任期一样。目前他的助理、他的老婆、他的团队、他的内阁都非常完美的安排，而且已经清楚的看到接下来五年会发生的事了。哎，这个很酷哦。OK， 所以不是只有我们，所有左派的人其实都知道，总统其实不是拜登，做决定的不是他，他其实就是一个下乌鸦的稻草人。我们只要把这个没有用、没有任何思想的植物人推上去选赢了 ，OK， 他的助理、他的内阁、团队、老婆就可以继续运行这个国家了。多蠢！就像中国古代的时候推上去一个三岁大的皇帝一样，谁当皇帝不重要，反正有大臣跟亲王会帮我们做所有的决策，让我们继续统治世界。报道上继续讲说， 但是川普的任期是天命跟命运对他傲慢进行的报复例子。美国政党和领导人凭借着我们的权力和卓越的地位，享受长期以来美国人拥有的自由，可以绕过我们的弱者和缺陷已经大大的减少了。这写什么东西的报道啊？ OK， 中文翻译之后我更看不懂，英文我也不知道在写什么东西。总之就是这个人写了一大堆废话之后，他写下了这一段，这一段才是重点。不管是不是已经确定了，但我不得不期待类似的戏剧化的惩罚，因为要把正在衰落的拜登刻意放在白宫。我读得好痛苦哦，一堆很大的字，用了一堆形容词来形容故事，但是目的只是要释放一个非常简单的讯息而已，就是他们现在疯掉了，他们不确定这个拜登能不能再好好的做第二任总统，而且很明显就是左派逼宫拜登的计划已经开始了，就连 CNN 也加入了他们的这个逼宫行动，或者是他们难得爆出了真正的新闻。
And he has done, I don't know if it's similar things, but he's sort of told some stories that don't line up.Quite like this before.
Yeah, this president has a pattern at this point of either inventing or embellishing stories about his own past, his biography. He did it three times in one speech last month alone. He claimed he had witnessed a bridge collapse in Pittsburgh when he actually showed up about 6 hours later. He claimed that his grandfather had died just days before he was born himself at the same hospital. In fact, his grandpa died more than a year before in a different state, not the same hospital. And he also repeated a favorite false story that I and others have debunked over and over again about a supposed conversation with an Amtrak train conductor he was friends with, who was actually deceased at the time the conversation would have had to take place. And that's not all. There are some more serious ones, in my view. Previously in his presidency, he claimed at one point he'd been arrested during a civil rights protest, when in other versions of the story, he just said an officer had taken him home from a protest. He said he had visited the Pittsburgh synagogue where worshippers were killed in a 2018 mass shooting. In fact, he had actually spoken to the rabbi, but never went. And he's made a whole bunch of others too. He said at one point, Republicans like to bring this up, he said that he used to drive a tractor trailer, used to drive an 18-wheeler. Never happened. The White House later clarified he used to drive a school bus at one point as a job briefly. School bus, of course, not an 18-wheeler. So whatever his intentions, whether it's, you know, foggy memory about stuff that's going on decades ago or deliberate embellishment, this is an unfortunate pattern that keeps coming up again and again with Joe Biden.
所以就连民主党跟主流媒体好像都开始慢慢转向了，或者是背叛拜登了，或许是要开始使用另外一个人来取代他的行动，因为很明显川普在各式各样的民调上面都大赢特赢，就连 CNN 做的民调川普也都在赢，这是前所未有的事情，纽约邮报甚至高达3个百分点。然后不管他们再怎么吹，再怎么说这个 Bidenomic 拜登经济有多好多好好棒棒，经济复苏了，根本没有通货膨胀，我不知道他们是怎么看的啦，我只知道我们洛杉矶这边的油价现在已经超过6块，快要7块了，又到7块了。然后根据最新的对于经济的这个前景的民调，上面问了一个非常简单的问题，你认为现在的经济正在 20% 的人认为在进步啊，70%的人认为说在衰退。下一个问题问到，你现在相信谁可以解救现在的经济困境？47%的人认为是川普，36%的人认为是拜登。其中没有党派的人有46%的人认为是川普，26%的人认为是拜登。最新的报道，拜登在 Iowa 的支持率大跌19个百分点，女人以及年轻的投票人开始放弃他了。简单的说就是。他们现在开始疯掉了，他们在几个礼拜前还非常有信心的，非常有自信的，认为川普完蛋了，起诉了4次还能怎样，真的纸包不住火了。不过我们也不可以高兴的太早，我们不可以自满， 不可以自大，我们还是要做到我们的最好才可以。还记得2022的红色海啸吗？结果完全没发生，跟我们加州这个百年一见这个飓风一样，风静浪平息。我们要做我们该做的事情，不管别人怎么说。那天访问林医师的内容我觉得非常棒，他有他的观点，我有我的观点，他支持 Ron DeSantis， 我支持川普，他说的很有道理，而且都是事实，他说的内容我们之后再开一起讲。 我也会讲为什么就算 Ron DeSantis 有这些特质，我们还是应该投票给川普。不过下面的留言真的是让我大开眼界， OK？他们希望美国变得跟中国一样，变成一个一言堂。他们希望有一个独裁者，然后威胁说：“你再这个样子的话，我就不看你的节目了。” I don't care, OK? 只因为林医师跟你的政治观点不同，你就应该封杀他。你的行为跟左派、跟中共有什么差别？雅各书一章22-27节，你们应该做行道的人，不要单做听道的人，自己欺骗自己。因为人若只做听到的人，不做行道的人，他就像一个人对着镜子看自己本来的面貌，看过走开以后，马上就忘记自己的样子。唯有详细观察那使人自由的全备的律法，并且时常遵守的人，他不是听了就忘记，而是行出来，就因自己所做的蒙福。如果有人自以为虔诚，却不约束他的舌头，反而自己欺骗自己，这人的虔诚是没用的。在父神看来，纯洁无玷污的虔诚就是照顾患难中的孤儿的寡妇，并且守护自己不被世俗所污染。这两章是关于林医生的报道， okay, 是他在所有左派压力下， okay, 在被政府吊销他的医师执照下，在疫情当下帮大家开医为俊树的一个医生之一。他是一个有勇气的人，而且是愿意出来发声的人。他是被左派发上报纸攻击的人。这些都是我们没有经历过的事情。他的观点你可以不同意，但是在这边人身攻击，说别人不是基督徒，我们 AI News 不怕你不看，不怕你不转发。我们没有跟 Google 或 YouTube 拿过任何一毛钱，广告的钱我们也没有拿到，所以我们不在乎。守护言论自由是我们身为美国人的职责。你当然也可以说骂 Ethan 骂林医师也是你的言论自由，没有错。但是我想要说的就是，这些在下面骂的人，希望封杀别人的人，就是希望美国大乱，希望美国独裁，希望美国变得跟中国一样一言堂。他们可能是中共的间谍，可能是联邦调查局 FBI， 或者可能只是 Noni Nokoru。我们应该做行道的人，不单做听到的人，自己骗自己。我们要翻转美国，是要自己付出行动，自己愿意牺牲，而不是在网络上在那边留言骂其他的保守派。左派这么多其他的频道，你怎么没去骂？假保守派这些键盘侠，你要骂就来骂，我们一点都不怕。And frankly, we don't care. 感谢大家收看，我是 Ethan， 更多美国情报请持续关注 AI News。